I'm Namrata Purohit and welcome to my channel. So we've spoken about the basic principles of Pilates and hopefully you all have watched that video because that is essential to be able to understand Pilates, the warm-up and the exercises here on. So yes, if you haven't watched that, watch that video first and then come back to this. In this video, I'm going to teach you all some basic Pilates warm-up exercises that are going to put all the basic principles in play and also get your whole body moving and activated. So we're going to start with isolating the shoulders. Simple thing to do is a simple elevation and depression. So it's just elevate and depress. Up and down. You do that 5 to 6 times. So do it with me and we've got 2 more to go. Up and down. From there we do a protraction retraction, so just get your hands forward, try and reach for something in front of you and then squeeze your shoulder blades back. Reach for something in front of you and back. Start breathing, remember the core engagement. So you exhale and reach, inhale and back. Exhale and reach and back. Last one, reach forward and take it back. So this was the shoulder principle. Remember, find your neutral and also keep your core engaged. So now we're going to do the arm circles, a simple exercise to kind of isolate the muscles and get it warm. Reach your arms out to the side, inhale and exhale to start moving them forwards. Small circles, controlled movements. Remember not to elevate, keep it relaxed. Just circle. I think we're on 5, 6. We're going to do 15 each way. 7. Exhale, 8, breathe, 9, remember all your principles, 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, the other way, 1, 2, 3, inhale through your nose, exhale through your mouth, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. So this has nicely warmed up our entire shoulder region and helped stabilize it. From there, we're going to go into what's called the cat stretch. So it's a lovely stretch to kind of isolate the spine and get the articulation of the spine. So a slight extension and flexion of the spine. What you have to do is get onto all fours. So getting into the cat stretch position, you're basically going to put your hands under your shoulders and your knees under your hips. They should lie in the same plane. So what I want you to do is put your hands there. Inhale, you go into a slight extension of the back. So as you can see, I've extended the back a little bit. Exhale, I'm articulating, starting from the lower back, going all the way up. Then as I open, I release from the lower back, mid back, upper back, and slight extension. I don't want you to sink completely, it's just a slight extension. Exhale, roll up. And inhale, release. Nice and easy. You should feel the each vertebrae articulating. Exhale up. Inhale, release. Let's do 2 more. Exhale up. Inhale, release. Last one. Exhale, roll up. And inhale, come back to neutral. So basically what we've done is we've articulated the spine. So you've gone into a slight flexion and a slight extension, articulating, getting the spine warm and mobilizing the entire spinal area and the entire joint out there. This also gets the back warm, also engaging the core, and also gets your shoulders and neck to get warm and relaxed. From there, we're going to go into the hip roll. So all you have to do is lie down, feet hip distance apart. So many of us tend to think that our hips are bigger than they are. Don't do that. Your hips, by your hips I mean your sit bones. So keep your heel in front of your sit bones, feet parallel. Make sure your knees are not dropping out, keep them straight. Just roll down and relax. Now out here, I need you to remember what your neutral is. As I had said, your hip bones and your pubic bone should stay in the same area. So if you put your palms on your hip bones and your fingers on your pubic bone, it should point straight forward. It should not point upwards, nor should it point downwards. So you stay in neutral. Find the neutral area and relax. Staying there, hands down by your side, we're going to do the hip roll. As the name suggests, we're going to roll the hip upwards. So from your neutral, I want you to go into slight flat back, engage your glutes, exhale to roll up, inhale to stay, and exhale down. Again, this is also working on the articulation of the spine. So exhale up, inhale to stay, and exhale down. You're going to get your glutes firing, so I need you to squeeze your glutes. As I like to say, keep your bum smiling. So keep the bum smiling, squeeze your glutes. Exhale up, inhale down. My core is nice and tight, keeping it engaged. We have three more to go. Exhale up, inhale to stay, exhale down. Inhale, roll into the neutral. Complete the movement. So roll all the way up. Don't go too high. Keep it neutral and roll all the way down. Two more. Exhale up. Inhale, stay. And down. Last one to go. I want you to keep looking up towards the ceiling. Exhale up. Inhale, stay. And exhale down. So that's the hip roll. We've articulated the entire spine. You've got your glutes working, got your glutes firing, I hope. So always keep your glutes squeezed in the hip roll. From here, we're going to go into the ab prep, warming up the abdominal muscles and getting the head nod in and the basic movement of this area. So as we spoke about the head and neck principle, remember not to jam your chin in, not to leave it behind. Keep a fist distance between your chin and your chest and you'll be in the neutral position of the neck. You can keep your hands down by your side or behind your head, but I don't want you using it to jam your chin in or using it to tense your neck muscles. It's only there for a little bit of support. So hands behind your head, inhale to stay. Exhale, think there's a pencil under your ribcage. Squeeze that pencil. Inhale to come back down. We're going to do 10 of these. Exhale up. Inhale down. Stomach nice and tight. Staying in your neutral. I'm not lifting this up. Exhale up. Inhale down. So I'm not lifting my glutes. I'm not moving this area. This stays neutral. There's no movement here. There's only movement in the upper abdominal region. Exhale up. Inhale down. Three. Exhale. Four. Five, six, keep your core engaged, keep it tucked in, five, six, seven, exhale, eight, nine, and stay up there, don't go back down, stay there and we're going to pulse, small movements, just squeezing that pencil under your ribcage, four, five, six, we're going to do 20. 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. I want you to stay there and we're also going to work the obliques a little bit now. All you do is rotate and center. Side, center. I want you to think of taking your rib cage to the opposite side and not moving the lower part of your body, so no rocking. That's absolutely stable. Six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. So hopefully you've got your abdominal muscles firing, you've got your transverse abdominal connected, rectus abdominis and your obliques working, as well as the multifidus to stabilize so there's no rocking in this region. From here, we're going to go into the breaststroke. So we're going to work the back extensors, and then we're going to go into a little bit of a shell stretch. So now we're going to go into the breaststroke prep. We're basically going to work the back extensors, especially the upper back, connecting the lower back as well as the glutes. This is an exercise, but also a great warm-up. So now you're going to lie down on your stomach. So you just lie down. hands by your side, legs pointed. Squeeze your glutes, so glutes connected, hands down by side, looking down. Don't overextend your neck, don't jam your chin down either. Nose hovering off the mat. You inhale, get your shoulder blades together, draw them back. Come up into a slight extension and exhale down. I want you to think like you're rolling a pencil out. So don't come up and hyperextend your neck. Keep it in line with your spine and down. Inhale up, exhale down. Don't forget to draw your shoulder blades back. Inhale up, exhale down. This is 5. We're gonna go for 8, 6. Inhale to come up, exhale down, 7. Inhale up, no hyperextending, remember that. Keep your glutes squeezed, bum smiling as I said earlier today. And down. Last one, up, hold for that 1 second. And down. I'm sure you can feel your back warm as well as worked out just with this one exercise if you've connected it well. From there, because we've gone into extensions, we go into a shell stretch. Sit back on your heels, hands forward, head down and relaxed. This is to kind of ease off the spine after it's done a lot of work, the extensors. Stay there, just breathe, take a few nice deep breaths. Inhale through your nose, exhale through your mouth. 2 more times. On your next exhale, I want you to slowly roll up, articulating your spine. And head opens up last. So this was basically a simple Pilates warm-up. We've done glute work, we've worked the core, we've worked the back. We've also opened up the shoulders and isolated the shoulders. We've thought about the head nod as well. You've been doing your breathing, hopefully, after watching the principles. You've also kept your core engaged throughout. Basically, what you've done is the Pilates warm-up. These are challenging, but they've also warmed up your body well and got you ready for the set of exercise that you're gonna do after this. This in itself are exercises that comprise of a warm-up, so these are challenging on their own as well. But we generally use them at the start of our exercise regime. So get used to these, remember your principles, learn how to isolate your muscles, learn about your pelvic placement. Once you get these right, get ready for a challenging workout, because Pilates, I promise you, is not easy. We're gonna do that in the next video. So come back, watch the next video. We're gonna start with talking about the abdominals and on how to get flat abs. Come back and see you soon. And as I keep saying, kiss. Keep it safe, simple, and smart.